Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the PDC and welcome to the Premier League of Darts. Introducing on stage, former World Masters Darts champion from Bristol, the Flash, Mark Dutridge. And ladies and gentlemen, 12 times World Darts Champion, Phil the Power
Taylor tops the Premier League in both points and average. His average is 100.68 for each visit to the Oki and his 96 legs to date. A huge task then for Dutridge to break Taylor's unbeaten record. The referee is Freddie Williams. Our commentators are Sid Waddell and Stuart Pipe.
Well, who's going to win? Your vote tonight. The poll of polls puts Phil Taylor streets ahead in a racing cert to take up residence in the semi-finals. And that's why no party politics tonight, just some dazzling darts, unbeaten, an average of over 100, and desperate to go through the whole tournament without losing a match.
Greatest dart player who's ever drawn breath. Credit to the working classes. Grafted in three apprenticeships in the potteries, was given a hard grilling by Bristol, and now top of the world. Look at his opponents.
Well, Mark Dutridge, what a year, what an 18 months it's been for him. Really got himself back into contention. Crucial, crucial victory over Wayne Mardell last week with that magical 1-6-4 checkout.
And should have had Taylor really in our first out in. It was 3-1 up against the power in front of some rampant stogies. Should have had him, and I'll remind you, in the world final 4 months ago, he had 14 180s against Taylor, but most of the time he missed the doubles.
Yeah, absolutely right, Sid. If my memory serves me right, you have darts to go three, well, hey, like four sets to one up. Well, all learning experience. And this is the man that they're all trying to learn from and all trying to catch. So, 12 legs, all will be played. And Taylor getting us up and running here in Widnes.
95.
Good lads from the Huntsman here, Doc.
With Phil Jones, like an honour to hang out. And we've also got 20 lads wearing the proud badges of Runcorn Social. Down here to get the full benefit, eh, lads? Stick around.
Another terrific crowd here inside the Widnes Leisure Centre, and a really good start there for Mark Dutridge. You feel if he's going to win, if he's going to beat Taylor, he needs to break the world champion's throw early on. Another 140 would go down very well.
An expert on musicals, all the way from Hello Dolly to The Producers, this lad. Gonna have to look on the bright side of life here, and I fancy him to maybe get a point here. He's a class act, Dutridge. He's top of the scrambling in the middle of our table. The three who are on six are Part and Manly and Dudbridge. So I fancy Dudbridge out of those three to claw nearer the magic four top places. Well, Mark Dudbridge has come of age as a darts player, beaten by Taylor last summer in the World Match Play Final at Blackpool. Now, he may not, well, I was going to say, he could well have gone across for 18s, but wanted to stamp his authority on this match, and that was good thinking, Sid.
Said to Gary Newborn, if he can come out here blitzing like he blitzed in the first six sets of the World Final 4 months ago, the power look could look as sick
45.
As SpongeBob in the desert.
Arguing by 122.
Well, what a start this would be. Needs the treble here to leave the ball. Bullseye for a sensational start.
You won't be far out. Oh, 16th of an inch.
97. Will you require 137?
Defending the throw then, Phil Taylor. Treble 19, the throw now for the world champ. Double 10. This would be magical from the power.
Just inside the fat bit. And what a start. Fat 9. He now wants double 8s. Still a chance, 3/4 of the betaway, Matt, to open his account.
17.
Slack dart. Well, as I say, they've put their cross next to Taylor, some of these people on the ballot. Taylor should not have been given these chances. Dudbridge repeating the world championship. Failings. So as Bob the Builder says to Wendy, cancel a D. Big job on.
Dudbridge was... fantastic against Mardle with his finishing last week. I think it was the 10th leg of the match, Sid, before he actually missed a dart and a double. And if you're going to beat Taylor, if you're going to threaten Phil Taylor, you have to make a good start and you have to get your doubles. A lesson learned by Mark Dudbridge in two major finals over the last 9 or 10 months. Clearly from that first leg, it hasn't been a lesson learned.
Taylor sitting astride this, like Clay Patterson and Morgan, he just stride the word like a colossus. Here he goes again on the maximums. Unlucky. He is leading the averages here, 100.6. He's leading the legs won, and he's leading the chart, at least legs lost. And he's not finding that 60. So,
95.
Overall, Taylor's average, 100. Only 96. He's really finding that 60. Sweet as a nut. He's the better on the 60 at the moment. Dudbridge.
140.
Yeah, Dudbridge, a very impressive start. Averaging, Sid, I know we're only in the second leg, nearly 110. Taylor's average, 83. This is an opportunity for Dudbridge. You reminded everybody he was 3-1 up in their first meeting in Stoke.
This gets to 3-0 in his favour. I'm going to stop talking about 1 point and coming out the scramble. I'm going to stop talking about 1 point if he keeps this up. But again, sometimes that slack wrist movement comes in and dips away. Absolute hush here on witness. It's the maestro's fling. But Taylor, 16th of an inch out at the moment.
100.
So Dudbridge missing two darts to take the first leg off Taylor. Shouldn't miss here. Top for 1-1.
1-1 it is, middle of the bet. Game on. It's top of that heap. Lying fourth at the moment. Below Taylor, Lloyd and Shelton. Taylor just has not got the weight of his throw here in Widnes, right? That's atrocious by his standards.
100.
Well, Dudbridge gets married 2 weeks tomorrow, Sid, to his longtime partner, Gina. And I don't think you've probably ever heard of a man hoping to cancel his honeymoon. But Dudbridge is. Gets married 59. On the 20th of May. The semi-finals and finals night in Manchester at the end of the month, of course. And if Dudbridge is there, the honeymoon is cancelled.
Well, I hope he does better on the ring finger than he does on the double sometimes.
60.
And Taylor sees slag body language. Trying to snarl himself on the power. Leads our lead top easy at 15. But look at this. The crippling consistency.
125.
Yeah, deflected out. It was going in there from Dudbridge.
Well, perhaps the power needs to change the batteries. Averaging 82.68 before these three darts.
He wouldn't win a game in the third team at the Huntsman Cup in Stoke-on-Trent with that average. That's what they came to say. Cavendish Andy as usual. Here in Lancs in Widnes. Where the pies in the rugby league bash has come from.
Fuel your requirement, 161.
Perfect lie to use the line. Atrocious use of the lie by that off.
45.
Wait, he's now got Tiller. Averaging only 87 to his 95. He'll never get a better bit of opportunity on his barrel.
Here we require 116.
Well, that match in Stoke needs a treble 17 to leave the ball. Now Dubridge hit 164. I was going to say
52.
That match in Stoke, this is how Taylor started. This is how he played.
Absolutely true. Average 87 for four legs. It was rubbish. Perfect angle to leave tops. Tops for a cripple at one in the soul. That flex is still on the wire. Already becoming a classic, Stewart, baby.
Well, if this is the hors d'oeuvre, the main course later in the evening is going to be very tasty. 2-8 for Taylor to rescue this leg. A leg where he's thrown really poorly. Taylor goes 2-1 up. And he's had on to himself. Not happy. Phil Taylor.
You can see during the next leg, watch when he goes for the double. The dart actually wobbles, Taylor's flight wobbles. Very pretty, but no cigar. Very pretty! Pretty recovery!
Well,
get anything for that.
That's accuracy, though, and he did well because he got the third dart in the treble. Well, Dubridge, in the two legs that Taylor has thrown first, has missed three darts to take them.
Now, on song, that would have been bang in the right-hand end of the bed. Chuck a block here! In witness, too much left, not enough adjustment.
60.
Goodbridge on six, as is Manley and Pat. In the basement, Wayne Martin's got a lot of fans here. Lovely adjustment by the power.
137.
You just get the feeling, Sid, he's beginning to warm up.
Often do we say that, looking back over his sheet, Taylor had a 10-2 against Shelton, early doors. Had an 11-1 against Margot. Trying to do them both 12-0. But I'm pretty sure the 12-0 was never in his psyche in thinking about Dudbridge. I know how much you respect this, lads, do.
135.
You think that Dubridge will one day win the World Championship, and so does Phil Taylor.
Credit to the game, credit to the Bristol area. Gave up his building jobs, they've got an interest in that. As Taylor now looks to take us to 3-1 with two clinical darts. Clinical, suit yourself. Well, that's a lie he might not choose to use. Well, you see, fell, but unusually for him, didn't know whether to use the lie or go clean over the middle. You don't often see indecision on Taylor. Quite capable of slapping these three together. Treble 8, he needs the ball. Just outside the required target.
56.
So once again, it's the Dublin that's letting down Dudbridge against the world's greatest ever. See, it's wobbling. Ah, it's not where they start from, Sydney boy. It's where they land.
In a case of what might have been yet again for Mark Dubridge. He's had his chances in this match so far against Taylor. At one stage early doors, his average was 83. It's now up to 92. He is looking menacing.
There's another cover here. 134.
It's another cover.
50,000 pounds for the winner of the Darts Premier League, the semi-finals and finals in Manchester at the end of the month. And Phil Taylor, well on his way to being Darts' first ever millionaire, has got his eye on the title. And on the dosh.
That's right. And him and Colin Lloyd at the moment. Look as though they can press their pants for the big dance at the end of the month in Manchester. Lovely. Oh, we just went not right there, though.
140.
So he makes trouble for himself by leaving one in the middle of the bed. Can't see him so tight to the barrel of the marker. Good bridge. You sometimes get deflection or lateral drift. No lateral drift there. He's not going to risk this one. Cover.
122.
The best player in the world and the most lethal when it comes to the cover, I would say. A good 8-9 times out of 10 when he comes down for treble 19, he gets it. This could be helpful.
140.
Very unlucky there. Only the barrel of the marker kept the last one out, as you see there. So precisely. Still for the power. Treble 18 is very handy for a 4-1 lead. Double 16. And look at that sneer of. Oh!
73.
I was going to say concentration. So far, three darts Dubridge has had to take legs off Taylor. He's going to have at least another one here. Two 13s. Big, big dart to stay alive in this match.
Mile
away. For right-handed throw, about 5 foot, five foot nine to six foot. That should have been an easy thrower. Now it is easy against the power, the double 16 for 4-1. And let the rampage begin. Like a piranha in a goldfish bowl. He likes the taste of flesh, this dealer.
Game on, please.
Four darts Dubridge has had, Sid. Two in the first leg of the match when Taylor threw. One in the third leg, another one there.
59.
And if you don't get Taylor when he's off the boil, he will come back and punish you.
Yeah, if you're on the boil, he'll answer it. 109 is their average each first nine darts. First three visits, they average 109. Their overall average now. 100 in the league to Taylor, went 3 to 92 mark. And Taylor's pulled that up from 86 to 96 in the last 5 minutes. Once again, though, the story of the World Championship 4 months ago being a good. Goodbridge handy on the scoring, but missing the doubles.
100.
Well, Dubridge simply has to win this leg. Throwing first, can't afford to lose any more ground, but he has to break Taylor's throw.
100.
That has proved very difficult for him so far.
He often has trouble using the lie at the left-hand end of the bed, Dubridge. As Taylor has no bother once he needs to cover up the treble 19.
100.
Oh, beautiful!
Well, Dubridge was driven up here in a white stretch limousine. His finishing has been akin to an old banger. And that's why he's losing 4-1.
100.
And it won't be red sauce on that banger. The way it's going. Could be similar colour of liquids. Congealing a bit faster. Taylor just now into that mid-rhythm. It's like Ricky Hatton saying, this fella isn't really hitting me as hard as I thought he would. Bow.
Treble 13 is the shot for Dubridge. Brilliant from the flash. But will he be back?
Takes all these two darts. That's only one leg he needs to get the draw anywhere. Dart not shaking now. Fat 17. Top of the shop. Oh, mile away by Ace Stannard.
Dart you require 24.
Big darts now for Mark Dubridge. Only needed one. And Dubridge is still very much up and running in the first match here tonight at Widnes. Taylor in front, only with one break of the leg. Taylor leads 4-2.
Welcome back, fans! Top darts and winners the Premier League. Phil Taylor, after a shaky start, catches in on Bad Dublin by Mark Dudridge. Leads 4-2 in the game that's up. Colin Lloyd, world number one, will have a rematch with Charlton. There were 10-180s last time they played Stuart.
Absolutely, and Wayne Mardle, four games to go, has to win them all to stay in the hunt against John Part, who's lost the last three. And Taylor's back against one dart Peter Manley to round the night off.
Talking about real stars, somebody special's coming your way tomorrow. All eyes will be on Ronnie there, Friday 7 p.m. live snooker. Premier League semi-finals, Mark Gauffo against Mark Williams. Stephen Henry against the man will be his last tango, Ronnie O'Sullivan. It'll be fabulous on Sky Sports 3. So will Saturday's final. Would like to say who'll be there. For old time's sake, I'd love it to be Ronnie.
The Rocket in action over the next couple of days. The power is dominating here. 4-2 Taylor in front against Mark Dudridge. And the reason being that Dudridge has missed his doubles. Simple as that.
60.
Taylor started the round with a fairly sloppy set like that. That produces legendary pub, the Haydock Huntsman. They even let Phil Jones in. Mark Dudridge looking very, very beautiful. Should have taken advantage of that lie, Stuart.
140 still good though. Taylor started with 60. This could be another opportunity for Dudridge. Only one break behind. And the stats telling you really. Well, look 100. At those. Dudridge, 8 shots of more than 140. And we're only in the 7th leg. Just one maximum apiece.
All eyes will be on this. Not just the lovely fans here and witness.
54.
But also particularly Mardle. Well, we'd be all looking at charts like that in the middle of the night. Taylor pulverized. This is begging to be in.
Your wish was his command. His second of the evening. He looked at a spot of bother in this leg. He knew it. And he pulls out three terrific darts like that.
Tight jockey in the grid, Alan Evans here. Full of oil. Other Gaelic equivalent, the juice of fighting spirit. Taylor, great respect for Dudders. Dudders desperate to get a point here.
Rare emotion from Dudridge as well when he nailed that one point. He left 167. Well, 164 last week. And he's making a mess of this.
Rather Taylor to go one leg away from at least the draw. It's a little 12 to the power. Fred Williams giving up the call there.
The eighth leg, Mark DeProto.
Remind you, yeah, Dudridge is one of three players on 6 points. Well, he is fourth.
16.
To Part and Manley by virtue of legs difference, won and lost.
Well, it's not often you can say that the rest of the pros in a tournament are willing Phil Taylor to win. And that's exactly what's happening here. Taylor win opens the door yet again for everyone else. And I think, Sid, Taylor's already in the semis. Lloyd has 1 foot at the GMX Centre in Manchester.
100.
The jockey for those two last places will go down to the very last night. Fortnight tonight in Colchester.
That's right. We're talking about your point. If they won't go in with your willing them in from 7 foot nine and a quarter, how will they miss from 150 metres to the balcony? Averages. Taylor was bobbling along on 87 for the first three legs, then bopped it up to nearly 100, matching his league average. Dudridge doing well to raise his average.
100.
But it's the doubles that's letting him down again.
And just when Dudridge thinks he's got an opportunity again, Taylor produces darts like this. Another one And you've got an opportunity of breaking the Dubridge throw yet again, and that surely would be curtains, of course. One more leg for Taylor, and he can't lose yet again.
That's right, but normally he'd have been into that left-hand end, like Alex Murphy around the blind side. Dubridge taking good advantage of the lie. It's been a fantastic, successful series, this. So we started in Stoke-on-Trent. And remember that scramble just win over Colin Lloyd in front of the Stokies. Lloyd's coming up in a cracker next against Shelton. That would be a belt. 10-180s in the match last week.
Dubridge has settled for this. Tops it is for Mark Dubridge.
Just a little bit too much air.
Too many misses. Too costly.
In most areas of life, one miss is enough. 2-12 for the power to get the point at least. No bother! Sent! It's a perfect dart! Because he means that tickle back to 10 degrees. He weighted that to within a millimetre of the face of the flock.
Dubridge, who was near perfect with his finishing, beating Mardle 7 days ago, has been
137.
Dreadful tonight. When he needed it most, his doubling has deserted him.
And see, the slight emotional tear much of the pituitary gland going. That's what happens when you play Taylor. The only weaknesses are that he sometimes leaves you 120, 130 shot outs rather than 160s and 170s. You never know which bit of his game will blip on any given night, but you know the blip's all it ever will be. He's got to take all the rest of the legs now. Dudda sweating.
100.
Yet again a case of if only for Mark Dubridge against Phil Taylor. And that has been the story over the last 12 months for the young man from Bristol. And he now knows, surely, he's going to have to win his last three matches. Otherwise, he can go on his honeymoon, because he won't be in Manchester if he doesn't.
Well, that's the beauty. It does produce massive games.
97.
And nobody better than Mardle and Dubridge in the later stages of this competition to produce the big games. I'm looking forward to to Shelton against Lloyd, coming up, the world number one Lloyd. Could be very tight, that. And they could sprinkle some more scratching dust on those lads on 6 points.
They're all cheering Taylor on. As a Taylor victory opens the door for everybody else. Yet again. Here we go, 84 again. The same shot as the last leg. 2-12s for victory.
He's got to go under the dart. It's shaking there.
Game.
Oh, perfect! He went through the flight. He used the flight as a marker. Look at the line of that dart. He was prepared to throw the dart an extra half an inch to get that line. Brilliant.
I'll tell you what's very important now for Mark Dubridge. In the count back for those last two semi-final places, it could 59. Well come down to leg difference. At the moment, Dubridge is dead level. Park minus 6, Manly minus 10, Shelton minus 10, and Mardle way back on minus 22. And Dubridge has to avoid a drubbing, because
100.
Those plus and minuses on the legs could determine whether he reaches the semis or not.
But he seems to have a handle on everybody's style. He knows that Dubridge is a surge 81. Player. He knows that Dubridge sometimes goes slack on the doubles. So now Taylor knows he only needs one more to get the 2 points to go top of the league by a mile on 17. So he can treat it like a practice session down the Millisackers pub in Stoke-on-Trent.
Well, I wonder if we'll see some exhibition stuff from Taylor. Or maybe he has too much respect for Dubridge. Certainly he can relax now. Another 2 points in the bag.
Only if you call cutting people's wrists off. Public entertainment. Greatest dart player of all time and ever will be. Get to my website if you want to argue it out. Greatest it ever will be. Missing that cover shot there, sloppy.
Just not finding the range. I think he came out
49.
With such a burst in the first three or four legs. He's tired now.
He beat Mardle 11-1 in Norwich. He demolished Roland Shelton 10-2 in Reading.
100.
His other victories have been 8-4 a couple of times and 7-5 a couple of times.
Has to get a 2-0 lead, if not better.
132.
Good response from Dubridge.
That's right. They play on because they. With all these guys bunched in the middle of the table, the leg count could be very important.
216s for another leg for Taylor. This will be four on the spin.
74.
He was halfway to St. Helens with that dart set.
Topsy ones. Topsy gets. Given that clutch of players, he's in. Fourth, fifth and sixth. Every leg vital. Because who gets that big dance in Manchester? Depend on single legs won or single legs lost. Lovely corridor opportunity for the power.
140.
And where did he go? The hard way.
A few bob in it as well. £15,000 guaranteed for getting through to the semis.
93.
Only three maximums in the match.
Yeah.
And there isn't going to be another
line. 177.
How often do we see that from Taylor?
If the first two darts had been a 16th of an inch to the right, he'd have gone there.
60.
Well, the king of the 180s so far, Roland Shelton with 29. Surprisingly, Mark Dubridge has hit only 13, Sid, in the tournament so far.
Was he at 14 in the world final? Also, Lloydie's on 27. So the next match should be a max fest.
Quite brilliant there from Taylor. And all Dubridge could do.
So if I was you, I'd give the cephalogy and the swing on with a rest. Get the metal chucking on Sky. More intellectual in politics. Double it! Cracks it in 8-3.
Important this though still for Mark Dubridge. He is throwing first in the last leg of the match.
Final leg, Mark to throw first.
So for three legs, he didn't average more than 87. And as we go into this last leg, Taylor is averaging 102.6.
I think said it slipped as low as 83 over the first couple of legs. That's the measure of the man. He's upped it over
57.
Nine legs of darts by 20 points.
Could give Darth Vader lessons in metal embellishment. He's got more than a dark side to him. I've heard he's karaoke, and he's good.
I'll tell you what, I may be mistaken, but I don't think he's missed going for the cover. Every time he's gone for the treble 19, he's got it. Well, here we go. Could this be one? Yeah, well done, Dubridge. He knows how important this leg is.
But look at the reply. Cover again, won't be far out.
137.
I've been absolutely demon-like on that cover to the treble 19 as
Taylor. Here he goes
sure
again.
You will again echo how much you respect this young man, and you're seeing why. Oh, look at you. This goes to the left. And this goes in off the one that's the marker.
100.
Only
100.
So Dubridge, the last leg. Can he finish with a flourish? Treble 18 would leave the ball. But what about this seed? 167.
Deliberately to show the lads I'm top of the averages. My average is nearly 101. I've won more legs than anybody. I've lost less than anybody. I'm a bit more of that power. The philosophy of Genghis Khan is that of Taylor. Two fours to snitch back. These legs all important. Double two.
Important misses from Mark Dubridge. That's been the story of his night on the doubles. Miss after miss after miss. This guy hasn't missed many. There you go. Phil Taylor, a cruise witness for the power. 9-3. He beats Mark Dubridge. Another great performance from Phil Taylor.
Phil Taylor, a missile in cruise control at the end. Coming up, what could be the match of the night, though? Well, number one, Lloyd, will play Roland Scholten. They both had 10 180s in their last match. Look out for good stuff.